Hey friends, glad to have you here. In this video, it's gonna be really real, very honest, a very deep look at some of the things that I've bought, some of the decisions I have made, and how they worked out for me based on packaging. You guys know there are some beautiful, cute, adorable, however you want to phrase it, makeup products that come out, and sometimes you're just drawn in by the packaging. Like, that's the thing that catches your eye, that's the thing that ultimately is prompting the purchase, and in some cases, it's been fine. Like, I've gotten the product home and I really liked it, and it all worked out. But then there are also those situations where it doesn't work out so well, and you're just left with a cute product that you're not really using. And I like to think of myself as a fairly practical person, you know? I'm a Capricorn here. I really like to think that I'm a good judge of practicality and usability and just really making the best product choices based on things of that nature. But cue up one of those little like Maury memes. Your latest Sephora order determined that was a lie. This was a total packaging prompted thing, and Sephora, I think they know that that's what's gonna happen with these products. This line of lipsticks they've put out called Lip Stories. This is just from the Sephora collection. Do you see this one that I got? I think it's called, yeah, it says Yum Yum on the side, and it's got like oatmeal chocolate chip cookies right there, and it just looks adorable. It's kind of a cardboardy packaging, and it's a cream lipstick formula. This is plastic though, which I like to see. The actual tube is plastic. I'm wearing that shade today, and I'm actually thinking it looks really cute. Like, I'm a fan of this color. It's like a deep brownish with a little bit of rose thrown in, and I'm really digging it. And I wore it the other day. I thought it had good staying power, felt comfortable on the lips. You know, it's a standard cream lipstick, but the packaging drew me in. I mean, you're gonna give me a tube with oatmeal chocolate chip cookies on it? I'm here for it. I also ordered another, but they didn't even send it. I don't know what's up with that, but the neat thing about their line is like every lipstick has a different picture on it, so that's the Lip Stories idea. Some of them were so, so cute. Okay, here's a frivolous lip purchase that I made that did not turn out so well for me. This is also from Sephora. It's from a brand called Incredible. There you go. It says Jelly Shot Lip Quencher. One of those lipsticks that has a flower suspended within the lipstick. Can you see it there? There's a flower inside, okay? Little pink flower, very cute. However, not impressed. I feel like it has a really waxy feel on the lips. It doesn't do anything for my lips color-wise. The shade on this, by the way, it's the one called It Was Only a Kiss. It was only a kiss. It's also having a real issue with being like too soft in the stick. So the stick itself, you can see these little lines where you're using it and it's really bumping up against the tube. Like, yeah, the flower's cute, but the tube seems kind of cheap, honestly, and the feel of it on my lips is just like waxy, not really moisturizing. I'm not a fan. Okay, friends, don't judge me. I bought a banana lip balm. Hey, I like the scent of banana, okay? Perhaps even more than the scent of an actual banana, I like the scent of banana candy, and this did not disappoint in smelling basically like banana runts, and I really like that. And this actually turned out to be a good lip balm. It's a squeeze tube here, so you just squeeze it out of the banana and you put it on and it feels nice. It's a legitimate like lip treatment. It will soften up your lips. It's by Tony Moly and it's just called Banana Lip Balm. And I'm pretty sure I got this from Ulta, and yeah, this could become kind of a stylish keychain, so there's that. Also from Tony Moly. I've had this in my collection for a while now. I'm gonna say maybe about a year or a little more. Yes, it has a panda on it, and that's precious. It's called the Panda's Dream So Cool Eye Stick. Well, the stick, I don't know if you can see in there, but it is completely shrunk. Like, you can see the outer, like, plastic of the packaging. It used to be just as wide as this stick. There's just not a lot of product in here to begin with. And I'm all for cooling eye sticks, and this is by far the cutest one that I own. But I look at other ones that I have here, like the e.l.f. Prep and Hydrate Balm and the Hard Candy Sheer Envy Coconut Water Stick. You're getting more product here and the same basic effect on the skin. Plus, those other ones don't seem like they're anywhere close to shrinking in size or anything, so I'm not sure what happened with that. Okay, let's talk about this, the new Too Faced White Peach Palette. Completely drawn in by the packaging to the extent that I barely really studied what was even being given to us on the inside here. I just like saw the outside. This appeals to me so much. I love this like lilac into white fade there. I think that's gorgeous. And in addition to thinking the packaging was adorable, I was also going off of past experience with the Too Faced Peachy Mattes palette that I love so, so much. So do you ever get that way with products where you've tried something in a line that you had such good success obsessed with. You buy like the next release almost instantly. But guys, sadly, I'm a little underwhelmed by this one. I gotta say, there's just not quite enough variety happening throughout this palette to really prompt a lot of different looks. Like, I'm looking at these top two rows and I'm just seeing a lot of sameness there. There are some really nice, especially matte textures to work with. Like, I'm wearing this in the crease today, this peach suede. I wore on the grill, like in my outer corner. I blended out the edges with a little bit of this creme de la peach. I tried to work with a little bit of glistening peach on my lid, but it didn't really come off very well. It didn't show up super nicely, so I've got some peach smoothie on there as well. And I've got some of the peach passion on my lower lash line. But I found a couple of these shades, like glistening peach and peach ice, to be kind of dud flaky type shades. And I just feel like it's a situation where I'm going to get the same kind of look every time. It's going to be a pinky peach type shade, like on the lid and in my transition-y type color, and then this cool kind of near black grayish color really defining the look for me, and that's kind of what it comes down to. The strange thing is that you look at the original, the Peachy Mattes palette, and you think, well, gosh, everything in that palette was matte. How much versatility did that really have? But I felt like that had a ton of versatility for me, because there was just like the perfect balance of light and medium and dark, and then within each of those shade ranges, there were enough different tones that really allow for some different looks. And this one, you know, I get it. This one's a little more orangey. There's some more that are cooler and more pinky. But on the whole, it's a situation where I like saw this. I thought it was gorgeous. I got it home and I thought, well, the shades that I might reach for most, I probably already have. I definitely already have like elsewhere in my collection. I'm just a little underwhelmed. Guys, if this next situation wasn't buying something for the packaging, I don't know what is. This is a little trio of blushes from the Balm. It says Girls Getaway Trio, and you're getting the Balm Springs, Balm Beach, and Balm Desert shades in here. So three blush shades. And you guys, I already owned two of these. And yes, I knew that going into the purchase. I knew I already had Balm Springs and Balm Desert. I bought this whole palette just for like one new shade. I thought it was cute. I kind of collect stuff, I guess, from the Balm, but is that good enough of a reason to buy something when you've already got two out of three? And guess what? Balm Beach turned out to be the most underwhelming shade in the whole palette. Like, it shows up very, very lightly, very barely there on me. I love Balm Springs. I think that's a really, like, universally pretty blush. And I like Balm Desert, too, because this one doesn't actually come off on the skin so much like a standard bronzer, like you might see it and just assume that that's a bronzer. That's actually got a little dusty rose tone in it for me, so that makes a gorgeous neutral blush. For someone who doesn't already have these in singles, you might like this. Fair skin might love that blush, like the fairest of the fair, or, you know, you can use it to kind of tone down other shades, perhaps. But let's just say you already own two out of the three. You don't really need the palette, although it is adorable. Don't get me wrong, I still think it's adorable, but I didn't need it. Here's another palette I bought from the Balm because I thought it was so cute, and it's their Nude Beach palette. So this is kind of in their, I think, like Nude Tude franchise. They had Nude Tude, Nude Dude. Now we've got Nude Beach, and perhaps even cuter than this outer box is what's going on here on the inside. Oops. I mean, come on, you guys. I can barely focus on the shades for the fact that there are these cute, like, nude people standing behind the colors. Like, it's so cute, but in all seriousness, it's almost hard to hone in on the color scheme that's happening here. But yes, it's a lot of warmth. The Balm does beautifully textured eyeshadows, and I really have gotten some pretty looks with this. But I even bought this, like, after I'd gone through much of the warm eyeshadow palette craze, you know? So many brands putting out the warm palettes. I already had a lot. I didn't need this at all, really. And the pans of product are actually quite small. When you really get to looking at those, there's a lot of exterior going on here, and then the pans are a little bit, I don't know, shrunken in. The more I look at the colors, the more I'm like, yes, they are beautiful. I want to bond with this palette some more because I'm seeing the pinks, like mauvey pinks, and also warm terracotta shades. Bronzes look beautiful, and the textures are wonderful. Oh, and by the way, I do have the new Meet Match Maker palette. That one was sent to me, though. All these things that I'm talking about in this video, like, I've been drawn to buy and pick up myself, but that one happened to be sent to me, and I will be doing some kind of a review on that soon. But yeah, as far as this one goes, I don't know, guys, did you find this, if you have this, did you find this to be a whole lot different from a lot of other just neutral, warm palettes that are out there, because it does sort of turn out similar looks. I'm a little on the fence still about whether I think that's truly worthwhile, and I think I will give it some more shots for sure. Okay, the CoverGirl Peacock Flare. This is a very eye-catching tube, you guys. I mentioned this, was it my last video? One before. It's one of those flexible rubber bristle brushes. It's pretty defining. The formula I would describe as borderline on the dry side, and I kind of like that with my lashes. It's one of those mascaras where I enjoy it enough to where I think I'm gonna use it for the duration of this mascara's lifespan, you know, I'm gonna go ahead and use it up. But I don't really love the effect as much as my L'Oreal Lash Paradise, but it's still, it's a good mascara. It's a solid mascara. Here's another frivolous lip balm purchase. I don't need any more lip balms. That's the thing. It looked cute. It's the new Lip Smacker. Walgreens had a whole lineup of these super cute lip smackers, and this is the Kiss Therapy SPF 30, and the scent is called Super Fruit. Do not be surprised if you see this in an upcoming favorites video. I'm congested, and this is still coming at me. This is so good. Oh, it smells so nice. So fruity, so sweet. A little bit exotic and tropical. It's so good, and it feels so smoothing on the lips. I'm gonna be glad that it has that SPF in there come summertime, but it's super cute. It's a nice little lip prep step as well. I do not regret the purchase whatsoever. The last thing, if we wanna really talk about being drawn in by cute packaging, I mean the Besame Snow White collection. It's so cute. When you think about a Disney type collection, there's a lot of different ways this could have turned out, right? It could have turned out looking a lot more cheap, a lot more cheesy, you know, but they just went the route of classic and beautiful. And I don't regret the purchases, especially the Ever After Translucent Pearl Powder. Still love and enjoy that. The classic Snow White Red Lipstick. Love, love that. Another one of the biggest hits from what I tried was the Cream Rouge. You know, this is fantastic. Really nice texture, really beautiful on the cheeks. I think would be beautiful on so many skin tones. But there were, I think, a couple of parts of that collection, like the Storybook Eye Palette. That's a gorgeous eye palette. It does have some beautiful shades in there. If I'm completely 100% honest with myself, it's not the kind of thing that I'm dying to reach for and put on my eyes every day, but I'm very glad I got it more from a keepsake standpoint. Like, I really am glad I didn't miss out on that, you know? The lip balm tins, I've got those over on display in my TV stand area. Those were cute. They were kind of this same size, except Snow White's face wasn't gold, it was more just skin tone, and they're cute, but not really that amazing as far as lip balms go. So if you're wanting that kind of look, you know, Snow White's face on something, I would go for the Cream Rouge and maybe skip the balms. I could have gone without those and still have had plenty of Snow White cuteness, right? But guys, for now, that kind of wraps up my video on situations where I've been definitely drawn in by cute packaging and whether or not that worked out. As you can see, in some cases, it totally did still work. The product on the inside ended up being good. I don't have to feel guilty about the purchase, but in other cases, I'm like, whoops, you know, that sucked. I think it would be very entertaining to hear your stories in the comments section, situations where you've either loved or not loved something that just drew you in for the fact that it was cute. So thank you for watching, guys, and I will see you again next time. Bye.